Very good morning to you all. Before starting, I wish you all a happy Independence Day. Fine. And you should know that the limits of your life, and you should know the true meaning of freedom also. When India got independent, fine, 75th Independence Day we are celebrating, but what do you mean by totally free? Independent means you should be able to take your decisions, but by paying attention to your elders also, side by side. Fine. We should not have conservative thinking. We should be free from all the shackles or rigid thinking. Fine. One should be flexible enough in life. So this is the true meaning, and it varies from person to person also. So let's continue. This is the last topic we have, subject verb agreement. Clear? Before starting, I'll be telling you, everybody knows that what is the subject, the topic which we are talking about, or the person we are talking about is our subject. Clear? And verb, what is a verb? Verb is an action word. Fine? And now we are saying subject verb agreement. Means both of them, they have to... Verb has to agree with the subject, and it depends upon the subject only. Clear? I'll be writing the one sentence, then it will be more clear to you. So let me tell you, subject verb agreement is also known as concord. So one and same thing, don't get confused. Subject verb concord also, or subject verb agreement also, both are same. Clear? So I'll be writing one sentence. First is, I say, he is a good speaker. Fine. Here we are using, our subject is he, and our helping verb we have used here is. Fine. And now I'm writing, they are good speakers. Are, is. These are our verbs here. Now, it depends upon our subject that what we are writing here. What's my point? It depends upon our subject. That what do we write in verb? Clear? So verb has to agree with the subject to make the complete sense of the sentence. That's why it is called as subject verb agreement. Can you write that he are a good speaker? Can you write they is a good speaker? No, because agreement of subject and verb is not there. Clear? So this is the basic in very layman's language I'm telling you, that subject and verb agreement, what it is all about. Clear? Meaning is clear to all. So keep on sending me feedback, students. Riyanshika, you can ask students in notebooks group to join immediately. I guess there are less number of students joining. There are changes in the timetable. Sometimes they forget also. So I have given reminder many times to you. So let's continue. Now we will be doing, I'll be sharing the screen with the students, because only 4 students are present today in the class. For you, I will be writing on the board. Clear? But the rest of the students who are at home, I'll be sharing the screen so that you can see the various points to be noted. Clear? The basic principle of subject verb agreement is that singular subjects need singular verbs, plural subject needs plural verbs. So we will be doing the rules now. Clear, beta? I am writing on the board also. For the children sitting at home, I have shared the screen. So rule number one, number. Very easy. Clear? The basic principle of the subject, I'll be using the word SV, agreement, SVA. ठीक है, जहां पे मैंने SVA लिखा means subject verb agreement short form में. So otherwise we avoid writing abbreviations in English, but just to save our time. So the basic principle of SVA is that singular subjects need singular verbs. Singular subject, first rule is this, needs singular verb. Clear? So children sitting at home, you also keep on noting down. I'll be seeing your notebooks. You will be writing singular subjects need singular verbs. Clear? And plural subjects need plural verbs. What is the example? It's in front of you only. This is the example. You can change it. He likes sweets. You write down one example. He likes sweets. They like sweets. He likes sweets. They like sweets. One more example. The boy has gone to school. The boy has gone to school. The boys have gone to school. Fine. Clear? Singular subject is boy. Singular verb is has. Plural verb have. Plural subject hamara kya hai? Boys. Fine. So example is the boy has gone to school. The boys have gone to school. Clear ho gaya? Kaise likhna hai aapne? Like this. सिंगुलर प्लूरल. और अगर ऐसे नहीं लिखा सिंगुलर, एक जो सेंटेंस पहले लिखे ना उसके आगे एस डाल दो, पी डाल दो. डोंट कट एंड पेस्ट इफ यू राइटिंग इन द पेयर. गॉट माय पॉइंट? ऐसे भी लिख सकते हो सिंगुलर एंड देन प्लूरल. ठीक है, और लाइक दैट टेबल भी बना सकते हो. दैट इज योर चॉइस हाउ यू प्रेजेंट द थिंग्स. फाइन. So this is our very first rule. Very easy also. Let me raise the board and then I'll continue with the rest of the rules. Yes, Vita. Next rule is person. As you can see on your screens, number 2 is based on person. First was based on number, second is based on, beta, it's not in your book. Make sure it is there, topic is there, but a lot of confusion they have created. Yes, the rules regarding the person are: the first person singular or plural takes a singular verb. Like abhi maine likhna nahi, aapne pehle samajhna hai. They are trying to say person. Now, what do you mean by person? How many persons are there in English? 3. Fine. I, you, and we. Clear? Ab hamara first person kaun sa hota hai? Pehle batao. I and we. Isko hum first person pronoun bolte hain. I and we ko. Fine. Let me see. Those who are sitting, they can switch on their videos. I can ask any one of you so that I can see whether you are sitting there or not. Clear? So I and we both are first person pronouns. So rule is that first person singular or plural takes a singular verb. Means I like this scene, we like this scene. It remains the same. Clear? Chahe I use karo person, chahe plural ho we. ज्यादा जनो, बट इट विल बी टेकिंग ओनली फर्स्ट. क्लियर? first person singular or plural takes a singular verb. So write down the example. You need not write I and V here. You just write the rule. The first person means I or V जो होते हैं singular or plural takes a singular verb. Takes a singular verb. I like this scenery. We like this scenery. Example is I like this scenery. Spelling of scenery, beta, kindly check. We like this scenery. Clear? Whether it is I or we, singular or plural, it will be using singular verb only. Clear? Now, how many persons are there? Two, three. So, second person ki baat karte hain abhi. Second rule says, the second person, singular or plural, takes a singular verb. The second person. Kaun hota second person? You. The second person, bracket mein likh lo, singular or plural, chahe ek ho, chahe zyada, takes a singular verb only. You like this scenery. Example, you like this scenery, full stop. Third rule, we are talking about now third person. There is a variation now. Clear? Isme to same hi hai. In first person, singular or plural, it takes a singular verb. Second person also takes a singular verb. Now, write down rule number three. The third person singular, takes a singular verb. The third person singular takes a singular verb. Now, what is the example of third person? He, she, it, Rahul, Ram. Means we are talking about any third person, but he is single. Tab kya hoega? Single verb he use hoegi. For example, he likes this scenery. For example, third person singular wale ki example likh lo. He likes this scenery. Fourth rule. Isi ka fourth. The third person plural takes a plural verb. The third person plural takes the plural verb. For example, they like the scenery. They like this scenery. ठीक है, plural verb लगा दिए बाप. They like this scenery. Clear? Any doubt, beta? Yes, third one. Third rule is, it's about uncountable nouns. Nouns which cannot be counted. Give the heading. Uncountable noun. With this mic, we have to be very careful. I'm going to see the notebooks of children sitting at home also. So make sure you are writing, beta. Baad mein koi bhi nahi likhta hai fir. Aapki final notebook checking bhi hone wali hai. uncountable noun. Write down, when we use an uncountable noun कौन से होते हैं, जैसे abstract nouns होते हैं, honesty, fear, in that way, ठीक है. So write down, when we use an uncountable noun as the subject of a verb means when we talk about honesty, truthfulness, fear, etc. इसका मतलब ये है, ठीक है. Comma, when we use an uncountable noun as the subject of a verb, comma, we use a singular form of the verb. We use a singular form of the verb. For example, honesty is the best policy. Honesty R नहीं लिख दोगे यहाँ पे. Honesty is the best policy. One more example. Fear begins to haunt him. Fear, F-E-A-R. Fear begins to haunt, H-A-U-N-T. Haunt him, full stop. Honesty is the best policy. Second example is fear, F-E-A-R. Fear begins to haunt him. Clear? So you are, I'm talking about this subject verb agreement. Clear? This is uncountable noun which cannot be counted. So we use singular verb. Now fourth rule is, so we have many rules out there, 21 exactly. Wait, something happened. Wait. Yes, this one, singular and plural nouns. Fourth one is singular nouns and aap simply likh lo, singular noun takes a singular verb, plural nouns take a plural verb. Singular nouns take a singular verb, plural nouns take a plural verb. Fine, very easy. For example, the sun is about to set. The sun is S-U-N, sun. The sun is about to set. The children were swimming. Second example, the children were swimming. ज्यादा है तो verb भी accordingly लगेगी. Fine, singular है तो single लगेगी verb. This is very easy. The children were swimming. Now, next rule is one of plus plural. अगर ऐसे लगाओ, I give you the example. One of plus plural noun. What is the example of one of plus plural? Write the heading, one of plus plural noun. Then we use singular verb. Then we use singular verb. Beta, my voice is audible to you all. Fine. So write down one of plus plural noun. Then we use singular verb. ये लिख लिया सबने? In this case, in the case of one of plus plural noun, comma, we use singular verb, verb, full stop. Now, example लिखो. One of the birds. Now आप सोचोगे कि one bird की बात हो रही है, bird क्यों नहीं है? बेटा, it is always like that. They are saying one out of all the birds. इसका meaning है. इसलिए ऐसे लिखते हैं. One of the birds was chirping. यहाँ पे बहुत confusion रहती है. Now complicated होने वाला थोड़ा. पहले तो आपने easy level किया. You have done very easy level. Singular noun takes singular verb, plural noun takes plural verb. That is very easy. Now a bit of difficulty level is going to increase. Clear? What they are saying? They are saying when you are talking about one of plus plural noun, that one of the girls, one of the boys. Fine. Then you will not use plural verb. ठीक है? आपने singular verb ही use करनी है. One of the birds was chirping. Were chirping लिखोगे तो cross बजेगा. One of the birds was chirping. Example और लिखो. One of the students was talking. One of the students was talking. TALKING. Means कोई एक. But आपने was लगाना है वहां पे. ठीक है? और is और was और depending upon the sentence. Next is बेटा, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर ऑल द रूल. सिक्स्थ रूल इज लॉन्ग सब्जेक्ट. हमेशा सब्जेक्ट शॉर्ट नहीं होएगा. इट कैन बी लॉन्गर ऑल्सो देन यूजुअल. लॉन्ग सब्जेक्ट. सो इन द केस ऑफ लॉन्ग सब्जेक्ट, नो व्हाट इज द एग्जांपल ऑफ लॉन्ग सब्जेक्ट. अभी लिखना नहीं है, मैं आपको एग्जांपल देती हूँ. द चेयर्स विच आई बॉट रिसेंटली. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द चेयर्स. हमारा सब्जेक्ट क्या है यहाँ पे? यस, he's sleeping in the class. Better. So, the chairs which I bought recently means I'm talking about the chairs which I bought. Subject to aapka lamba ho gaya na yahan pe, longer subject. So in this case, what to do? When, write down, when a clause, C-L-A-U-S-E. What is a clause? Clause is a group of sentence which has its own meaning. ये सेंटेंस का पार्ट होता है, बट इसका मीनिंग अगर इसको अलग कर दो सेंटेंस से तो क्लियर होता है. फाइन, हमने किए हुए हैं ये तो सेवेंथ क्लास में. यू हैव डन. सो व्हेन अ क्लॉज और अ लॉन्ग ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स इज द सब्जेक्ट, व्हेन अ क्लॉज और अ लॉन्ग ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स इज द सब्जेक्ट कॉमा, we have to be careful. So देखो रूल कैसा है, ये आपके ऊपर छोड़ दिया उन्होंने रूल. We have to be careful to make the verb agree with the subject. We have to be careful. Careful में single L आता है. To make the verb agree with the subject. Now what does it mean? Two examples करेंगे, it will be more clear to you. वो कह रहे हैं कि when you have longer subject, that depend करेगा. कभी तो singular verb आएगी, कभी plural आएगी. Fine? And you have to choose yourself. Example number one, the chairs which I bought yesterday, the chairs which I bought yesterday are very costly. The chairs which I bought yesterday are very costly. Next is the woman whom I met in the market. Second example, the woman, W-O-M-A-N, singular hai, theek hai? The woman whom I met in the market was my friend. The woman whom I met in the market was my friend. Tell me the difference between the two. What is the difference of subjects in both the sentences? In first sentence, plural subject is there, chairs. And our verb is also plural. In the second sentence, we have singular subject, woman, one woman. And our verb is also singular. So it is simple, singular noun takes wala. Next is, now I'll be just making you write the example. Example se clear ho jana hai. Next is, seventh rule is, introductory there. Introductory there. T-H-E-R-E. Means agar beginning mein sentence ke there lagao. Seventh rule is, introductory there, T-H-E-R-E. Example likho seedhe. There is no chair in the room. For example, there, T-H-E-R-E. There is no chair in the room. Second example, there are no chairs in the room. Very easy. There are no chairs in the room. Again, aapka jo helping verb hai, kis pe depend kar rahe hai? Subject pe. One chair hai, to a zyada hai, to are. There are 50 boys in the class. There is one girl in the class. When we'll continue this topic because it is quite lengthy enough. Okay. So, let me make it clear. Aapki notebooks ka schedule I will be sending you, okay?